The field of quantum computing is incredibly important because it will be used where conventional computers leave off. We'll be able to tackle problems that are so hard that we basically ignore them in society right now. What about the stock market, optimizing a portfolio, or calculating the structure of a very complex compound molecule? So these are the types of problems that quantum computers will be able to tackle.
It's amazing that the foundation of what runs the world, quantum mechanics, has any application to technology at all. But it turns out that it has a huge application, and quantum computing basically explores that edge. Team science is really important and very critical because people bring in different strengths. So in our team, Jung Song is more of a systems engineer, thinking about how to build up systems in a constructive way. Chris is a world expert in atomic physics and ion trap quantum computing. And then I use algorithmic methods to make things more robust.
In order to build the computers that users can use, you can't just focus on the physics. You have to have the physics, you have to have the engineering, you have to have the software, you have to have the application layers that are integrated.
And we have the Duke Quantum Center, which is unlike any other center in the world in that we're embracing this vertical nature. Very hard for universities to do this because it involves physics, engineering, information science, chemistry, computer science, algorithms, different academic departments. Typically, they don't talk to each other. And at Duke, this seems to be in the DNA here.
The real strength of Duke that I have seen is its flexibility, because we're trying to do something that hasn't been done before. And therefore, we need a framework and support. The future of quantum computing in the next few years will be extremely thrilling. And Duke will be at the frontier of that.